the Sabbath goes back a long ways. It is a bedrock practice in Judaism. When God created the world, God declared that creation was good and rested on the seventh day. God commands humanity to do the same thing, to order our days in units of 7 days, which we do, and taking the seventh day as a day of rest. For Jews, the Sabbath is from sunset on Friday to sunset on Saturday. In the times of the Old Testament, every seventh year was a Sabbath year, and 7 times 7 Sabbath years plus 1, 50 years, became a Jubilee year. And during the Jubilee year, farmland was set aside to rest, slaves were set free, and debts were forgiven. The Jubilee year was like hitting the reset button on society every 50 years. The poor were lifted up a bit, the rich gave more to the common good. It was a predictable cycle based on the number 7 that ensured renewal in society. And this 7-year cycle might have biological roots. I find it interesting that scientists say that our cells in the human body completely turn over every 7 years. In Deuteronomy, God interprets the Sabbath as a celebration of the Exodus and the Hebrews' liberation from slavery. Now, the Hebrews worked 7 days a week under slavery, and in freedom, they would have a day of rest to commemorate their liberation. God also designed the Sabbath to be an opportunity for delight and renewal. When we turn away from our day-to-day labors and focus on our relationship with God. And we see that in our reading from Isaiah today, when God celebrates those who observe the Sabbath. God says, if you honor the Sabbath in its fullness, taking care of others and sharing your bounty, God promises that the Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your needs in parched places, make your bones strong, and you shall be like a watered garden, like a spring of water, whose waters never fail. In American religious history, the Puritans and later other Protestant sects kept Sunday as the Sabbath. It was a day of rest and worship that led to Sunday store hours and regulations on the sale of alcohol. Well, here in the Bay Area, setting aside Sunday as the Sabbath was probably never as widespread a custom. Many people came here to escape social conformity. And in the 21st century, Sunday has now become a day for youth soccer games, catching up on chores, and getting ready for the work week. Or working. Maybe we've come full circle to working 7 days a week like the Hebrew slaves. You are keeping the Sabbath today by setting aside this time to come to church and to worship together. In our gospel today, we see a conflict over the purpose of the Sabbath play out between Jesus and the leader of the synagogue. Jewish custom said that no work could be done on the Sabbath except essential tasks that were necessary, like tending livestock. I think it's helpful to look at the different roles that Jesus plays in this story. Jesus starts out as the authorized teacher in the synagogue. He is deeply rooted in the Jewish tradition and the Torah. As he's teaching, a woman arrives who is bent over. Luke writes, she had a spirit that had crippled her for 18 years. She was bent over and was quite unable to stand up straight. We don't know why she is bent over. And I like the fact that we don't know, because I don't really want Jesus to be just kind of a cosmic chiropractor. I think there's more going on in the story. When he sees the woman enter the synagogue, Jesus from the community. So Jesus calls out to her, lays hands upon her, and says, "Woman, you are set free from your ailment." She stands up straight and praises God. But the leader of the synagogue doesn't approve because this was an act of labor performed on the Sabbath. Jesus argues that the woman is a daughter of Abraham, fully a Jew, fully a human being who deserves to be healed even on the Sabbath, and maybe even because it's a Sabbath, a time of renewal and liberation. He argues that isn't she as worthy of care on the Sabbath as the donkey who needs to be led to water? In this part of the story, I think Jesus becomes what we would call a social disruptor of his own religious system. Now, as a religious professional, I have some sympathy for the leader of the synagogue. Like him, I am charged with upholding the religious tradition. In my ordination vows, I did promise to uphold the doctrine and discipline and worship of the Episcopal Church. I also trust Jesus and his discernment to disrupt the way things are usually done. To Jesus, the health and dignity of people, especially those who are suffering, is more important than maintaining social systems, even the conventional Sabbath. Jesus reaches deep into that meaning of the Sabbath, saying to the leader of the synagogue, "Ought not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan bound for 18 long years, be set free from this bondage on the Sabbath day?" Here Jesus reconnects the Sabbath with liberation from slavery, and as a time set aside to be freed from whatever binds us and distorts our lives. I think it's important to note that Jesus reaches out with compassion to heal a woman who had little status in her society. For me, she is also a metaphor for the status of women in our own society today, where systems are taking away the basic human dignity of women. Women right now are not considered capable of making reproductive health decisions, and women are suffering. Their lives are being burdened and bent by systems that do not respect their dignity as full human beings. And unfortunately, it's being done in the name of Christianity. In these times, I think it's important to meditate on the Jesus we see today. This Jesus is a healer and a liberator who affirms the dignity and worth of a suffering woman. This Jesus is an agent of love and compassion. This Jesus prioritizes the vulnerable. This Jesus shows us the meaning of Sabbath and asks us to live into it as well. And the good news is that Jesus teaches us and feeds us here on our Sabbath day so we can follow him. So I wonder what the spirit of Sabbath means for St. Paul's as you all move forward together. I wonder how you can become a place of Sabbath for the community, a place of spiritual renewal and justice. So many are in need, and we all yearn to rest in Jesus' Sabbath grace and